CEO survey, it has been seen that almost 50% of global CEOs are expecting to add headcount this year, but their concerns about the availability of key skills are at an 8-year high. The existing talent pool available is not sufficiently capable of addressing the needs of the industry, both at the fresher as well as lateral levels. In today's market scenario, in order to meet business growth, talent acquisition strategy must continue to expand beyond a tactical reactive function to a proactive streamlined approach. Doing so will enable them to source, assess, select, hire and onboard the best candidates in this competitive environment. Through this today's forum, we expect to come up with valuable inputs towards identifying ways to revolutionize the existing talent acquisition function, advance the talent acquisition strategy, as well as champion excellence at every stage in the recruiting life cycle. With this, I would like to welcome you all to this enlightening and pleasant knowledge sharing session this evening. Summing it up, I'd just like to say, just like to add one line, that is, be here, be vibrant. Thank you.
I look at talent as organizational capabilities. And what do I mean by that? Very simply, the way I look at this is, for my company, do I know what skills and capabilities are required to be successful in the marketplace in the future? That's the first step. So do I know what skills are required? Second is, do I have an acknowledgement and appreciation of what talent and skills do I have currently in my organization? So I know what the way of the future looks like, I know what my skills currently are, and then there is between the two is where the gap lies. I'm saying, do I believe that my internal approaches of skill building will help bridge that skill gap or not? And therefore, if I do not have the ability to be able to grow people internally or accelerate skill development in a fashion that can support my growth, then I need to look at alternate means of bringing people in, recruitment being one of them. That's for me very simply what talent is about and what talent means from an organizational landscape standpoint. And a few more threads around it. I think as we look at organizational capabilities for the future, I think it's also important that as a leadership team, as a CEO and the CHRO that is enabling this agenda, you have a much broader perspective on how you want to be able to support that agenda. Class examples, right? How many of you know the company called Research in Motion? What product did we use of RIM?
BlackBerry.
I think if you remember very distinctly, what was Research in Motion trying to do? Research in Motion was trying to truly build capabilities as an organization to be able to build smartphones. And they relied on internal capability and the belief that yes, they will be able to make that transition. But the fact of the matter was, what they did not anticipate was the disruption that was happening around them from a competitive landscape standpoint and the way technology was opening up around them. A classic example of an organization that was blind to multiple dimensions of building organizational capabilities. I think you see this very well in the pharma industry, right, where organizations with good R&D capability believe in the R&D capability in the hope that they will find a molecule that will in turn turn out into the next big drug discovery, but also actively are looking at alliances and M&A to be able to sustain themselves in the future. Example like Sanofi, example like more of a class examples of how some of these pharma companies are evolving. Apple is also a great example of how they have leveraged the ecosystem to be able to build a competitive advantage for themselves. And whether it is building alliances or whether it is through payment models, I think what they've been able to do is build capabilities for the organization. So I think for me, if I look at this whole talent landscape, I think two things stand for me. I think it's about looking at what business problems you're trying to solve with your CEO. Are you defining what business problems you're trying to solve? Does it translate into your HR workforce planning or capability capacity planning? And in that, are you using multiple dimensions of being able to bridge that capability gap? And this could be buying talent, i.e. hiring talent, aggressively developing talent, borrowing talent, right? And I think those are important threads that I think jump up to me as we talk about talent.